Hello, I'm Saltless, your editor, lecturer in Metallurgy, preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia-free. Now we have approached the end of the age, in which Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, is getting fulfilled. The parable of wheat and tare. The sower is the creator of male and female, Yahweh. We call him Brahma, and in Arabic they call KHUDA. The DEMIURGE, this part was created by Yahweh. The soul inside me is of Elohim, Allah, Abram, that our supernatural father, which is above our tribal father, Illah. That's why we call Allah is Al-Illah, the Father. So, chosen people, they are nice people, demonstration nation of the world. And Abraham was picked up from Iraq area to settle in Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and Yahweh gave them the promised land, Garden of Eden. So far they were faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. They enjoyed the best fruit of the world. As soon as they became unfaithful, the same land became barren, and they have to leave it. As in the prodigal son, Jacob had 12 sons. Out of 12, 11 were crook, liar, and unfaithful. John 8, verse 44. They were liars and murderers. Only one was faithful, which was Joseph, and they wanted to kill him. Instead, they sold him as a slave, and as soon as Joseph left the promised land, whatever meager they were eating, that also stopped. Yahweh won't give them the rain, and the land became barren. And then Jacob then told his sons, there's a grain in the Egypt. Go and buy from there. And Joseph, having the quality salt of Abraham, he helped them as much as he could. But they kicked him in the face when they returned back. And the Samaritans are the generation of those Joseph. They still carried the salt of Joseph. Where the other, they carried the salt of the patriarch. Still very clever people. So, when Christ Jesus came, they had also again become Jew of outwardly, not of heart. And they became unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh. And they were under Roman, and they were colluding with them, and Roman was using them as a stick. If they want to conquer anything, they will use their labor, their soldiers. So the Jewish people were supplying the soldiers, and the Roman were giving them protection. They were in collusion with each other. So when Christ Jesus came, as they have killed the as they killed the prophets sent before Christ Jesus, they also killed him. And then as stated in the parable of the wine press, the owner of the wine press, God, then took away the temple from them and gave it to the people who will produce fruit. That is in India now. This holiest of holy, where mosque is Al-Aqsa. It is in India called Golden Temple. You can't have two temples of God, only one. So this one is defunct. good for nothing, but they are fighting over it. So, you see in the videos that these Jewish people are spitting at the strangers, and now they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. So more and more Jewish people will be getting into the Israel. So they need land and houses. So that they will try to throw out the Gentile, Palestinian. They are their cousins, but they fight with each other because both are unfaithful to Abraham. Abraham was not a Hamza and all that thing, you know. He was Semitic race. So it's a very interesting subject, and they are the demonstration nation of the world, and you can easily understand what is happening. So the tares at the end of the age, I will bundle up the tares and burn them. So these tares are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning, and which is expected soon, because their protection years have passed away, protection time has passed away. On 14 and November 2023, the protection will pass away, and then they will be under the control of Elohim Allah Pabram, our supernatural father, for judgment day, which is atomic war. So atomic war can take place any time after 14 November 2023. So up to that date they are protected and there will be no harm. So what they are doing to these strangers, spitting at them and other things, is nothing to do with Abraham. They are not the salt of Abraham. They are the people who killed Jesus. What for? He was a good man. And all of you know that he was very gifted man. And the Jewish people, out of jealousy, they killed him. Even Pilate found no fault in him. And he gave it to them, do as you like it, but I don't find any fault in him. And the blood of this man is not on my hand. He washed his hand under sun. The Jewish people cried that blood of this man is on us and our children. And so it will be. So these are the people, as you can see, who killed Jesus, spitting at the strangers and all that, you know, so arrogant. And they have nothing to do with Abraham. Abraham is not their forefather. Most of them looks to be European or other one. Abraham gave a tribal mark to Isaac, which is circumcision. But this circumcision was floundered by the temple priest to make money. Anybody who wanted to sit in front of the temple, they created a partition in the courtyard. Anybody who wanted to sit in front and put on those gadgets, he had to become Jew through circumcision. So they will dish out the circumcision to Gentiles and the slaves, who had nothing to do with the blood of Isaac. And that's how they malpracticed for the money. And when they enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, then they introduce circumcision compulsory. circumcision and made them fake sons of Abraham. And Stephen, angel Stephen, went to the temple and told them, our forefather Abraham was a noble man. Do not make fake sons of Abraham. They were grinding their teeth and they took him out and they killed him. Today the same people are going to kill them. You cannot blame a third person. They themselves are to be blamed, and they created this fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. So this is the characteristic of the tears spitting at the strangers and all that, and that will have a bad reaction in the West and other countries. They will start spitting at the Jews and killing them, and they will be made to run to Israel to get bundled up. So these coming few months are very critical, and their protection will end on 14 November 2023, and after that atomic war is expected, which is in the name of Elohim Allah Abram, our supernatural father, against whom Tony Blair and Bush spoke blasphemy that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction, but none were found. White lie by the white men. So blasphemy is not forgivable. It is it is against the Holy Spirit, and it is punishable by God. So this is going to be God, judgment of the God, atomic war. So our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love. In Jesus, we speak like little children. We have nothing against anyone. We don't do favor or disfavor to anyone. We speak the gospel truth, whether you like it or not. It's not our, it's the word of our supernatural Father who lives in my heart. This is the temple of God. God lives in his temple, not in heaven anymore. Those people who say, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, This prayer was created by the Jewish people, the Messianic Jews, who wrote the New Testament. And there is no disciple in Christ Jesus, because the root of the word disciple is discipline, which the rabbi first is Rusi discipline by teaching the moral of Moses. In Jesus, we have Talmidim, which we call Sikh, our student of spiritual knowledge. No disciple. Disciple of one small, spiritually blind people. They go by what their rabbi tell them to tell them. So, Pharisee, Sadducee, John the Baptist, they had disciples, but not Christ Jesus. In Matthew it is stated. So, our Father God blesses everyone in agape, and we have no grudge in any against anyone.